Hello everybody, today we'll be doing convert sorted array to binary search tree. Given an integer array nums, where the elements are sorted in ascending order, converted to a height balanced binary search tree. A height balanced binary search tree is a binary tree in which the depth of the two subtrees of every node never differ by more than one. Okay, so the way to do this is that we have an array. This is very similar to a linked list problem, except in this problem, we don't need to break everything in half. That means that it is going to be a log n operation instead of log of n log n operation, because we know where the middle is by taking the length of the array. So length of the array is going to be 5, and we do a divided by 2 base, and we end up with 2 here. And so 0, 1, 2, that's it right there. That's our mid. So with that, we would be able to do this in log of n, because we distribute everything in half every single time. And we will be able to produce all of these binary trees. Yeah. Okay. So the space time complexity is going to be O of n, though, because we will need to produce the similar number of nodes to match the number of items in the array. So that's our case here. So as you can see, this is our output, and this starts with a middle node, and then this is our left node, this is our right node, and we take the left node and right node with that. This is one of the possibilities. This is our second possibility as well. Here we have a 1, 3 and a 3, 1. What is this? Well, this is the two possibilities of a binary search tree when given a number called a 1 and 3. So what are some edge cases that we can think of? So edge cases are, well, we can only choose, there has to be a length of 1. So minimum item is 1, so that's our base case. And our outputs will be a single node. So with that, we know what to do, and let's get it. The match is basically recursion, and the plan is to break the array in half and set root.left to be sorted array to BST of the left half. So we're going to take nums between the starting point all the way up until the midpoint, which we're not going to take. And root.right is to be sorted array to BST of nums. From we're going to take mid plus 1 and go all the way to the end. And the base case is an array of length 1. That's when we know that we should return, where we should return a tree node of that root value, without setting the root.left or root.right. So we just set it at root.val. Perfect. With that, we are ready to implement. Let's give this a shot. Don't know what's going to happen, but we know that we'll try, right? So if nums, length nums, equals 1, return tree node at this particular value, so at nums at 0. With that, we have created our item. Otherwise, let's get the mid equals so lang nums divided by 2. So once we get the mid, We are going to do something. What is that thing we're going to do? Well, tree node root equals tree node at the root, at the mid, nums.mid, and root.left is equal to the sorted array of BST of the left side. So nums from here to the mid, and root.right is equal to the sorted array of nums of mid plus one to the end. And with that, we can return the root. This should work pretty well, I hope. I'm not sure if there are any errors, but so let's run the test cases and see what we're missing or not missing, or if we're working or not working. So one thing is, we do need a self to run the code. We are running the code now. And let's take a look. Index out of range. So that's a problem. So the midpoint is no good. I think we have something. Our midpoint is no good, and we have to look out for a reason why the midpoint is no good. So let's currently we're testing our example case is 5 items. So we have negative 10, negative 3, 0, 5, and 9. So what happened was that we broke it in half, which is 5 divided by 2, which is we're going to get 2. So our midpoint is 0, I mean 2 at this point. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's our midpoint. So we grab our midpoint and we try the left side and right side. So we have negative 10 and negative 3 on the left side and 5 and 9 on the right side, which where we're gonna recursively do this operation on it. So it's not 1 yet. So basically we're gonna take, this is the length of 2, so we're gonna take 1. Basically we're gonna take the negative 3 and use that as our root node. So we create that as a root node and we go down to our left and right. So when we take our left, we have negative 10 on the left side, but we don't have anything on the right side. We have none on the right side. So we do need if not nums, return none. So I think that was the edge case that we missed. So let's run it. And it should work out this time. And so here, it has worked, and that way we are pointing to the right item. So let's test the test case, multiple test cases that we have set out to test. And we are good to go. And we're going to test out that one last item where we only have a single item. And let's run that code. That should just return our item. Perfect. With that, let's submit and see what's happening or what we might be missing or can we do this any better? And it looks pretty good. That's a nice solution. So I'll be back after looking up some more solutions and after solving this problem to see if anyone else has better code that looks better. And if you have any better code, please comment below so we can all learn together. So yes, we're back and we have some ways to simplify this code, but I also found out some information about this splicing technique where it's cost O of n to do when you do a splice. And so this makes it a n log n operation. Which is not what we our does not match our time complexity of O of log n. And also, when we're creating like n items, I don't see how that's log of n, although like we're not, yeah, we're creating n op n items. Doesn't that mean that we're doing at least O of n. So it's not going to be log of n, because we're looking at each single item, right? We're creating a brand new item each time, even though we're looking, we're dividing everything in half. We're still, what we're doing here is that we're doing a O of n operation to create it, because we have to look at every single item. With the splicing technique, people say it's a log n operation because the splicing takes time, and we do it log n times the splice. Is that true? No. We do this way more than log n times because we have to split every single time until it's a single item, and from every which point. So isn't that O of n? I'm not sure. So anyways, I think it's an O of n operation now. And there people do come up with, so let's clean up this code a little bit and let's make it just slightly cleaner. So we can do this in three lines apparently. So we just do this. So this is our second line. And our third line is going to be return tree node with the left and the right. So it's just going to look like this. Does that make it look better or less better, less clear? So I'm not sure what you guys think, but it is going to be three lines at this point. Let's run the code. What happened here was that we never finished close it up. So let's run the code again. And let's submit. Wow, slow. Very, very slow. Looks good, but slow. I think it's because we had to make additional operations. When we lost that line of code, we had to make basically double the number of operations because of each branch of the tree. And we're looking at, basically all the nodes and looking at none nodes. Well, here's what I mean. So suppose we have finished up like our 0, like negative 3, negative 10, right? And we had our 5 and 9 here. So what happens is that we don't end at this layer, this negative 10 and 9 layer. What we do now is that we end here, where we get to none and none. And we're doing all of these extra operations at the end, near the bottom half. So that's taking a lot longer that way. It's a lot fewer lines of code, but that's all it is. So people complain that the splicing itself is, using more memory. And a better idea is to basically, it looks clean, but it's actually producing a brand new array every single time, the splicing technique. Let me go look that up. So I was wrong. So slices hold references, not copies of array elements. If you want to make a separate copy, you would use deep copy. So how does this impact us by creating these slices of this one? We're not using any new memory. That's good. So I think that's why we have a pretty good memory usage percentage here. And so let's just return this back to original code. I think it's easier to read as well, so that's nice. And yeah, if anything else, it runs a lot faster than having all this code combined into a few lines. And there is another way to do this without splicing, but I don't know. Are we going to make deep copies, or what does that look like? So I think this is good enough for me. If you have any questions or comments, please comment below. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe. Want more videos, check the link in the description below. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next one.